Bildade is so proud to be part of this amazing, bustling city of gold. Come behind the scenes with us as we explore what really goes into the development, refurbishment and creation of this incredible city we call home. From past to present, we look at what makes Jersey unique and what the future holds.
Bildade on Mix 93.8, chatting about windows and how important it is when you're planning your home to understand not only can you look out the window, what is it made of? What are its insulating qualities and so on? And we're chatting tonight about UPVC. We've already spoken to Peter and we're now going to chat about aluminium and wood. And I have Mark Cross and Samantha Cross in the studio from Swartland. One of them is going to chat about wood and the other is going to chat about aluminium because the company supplies both types of window. But we're going to start with Mark and Mark's going to cover wood. Where I want to start, Mark, and I think it's pertinent to what we're talking about, is historically, we've always looked at wooden windows as something that you could buy off a shelf or out of a catalogue, etc. But you guys are now selling a complete unit. It's glazed, it's sealed, and so on. Tell us a little bit about this, because it's relatively new, is it?
Graham, yes, thanks. Yes, we've got a pre-sealed and glazed product that we call Ready to Fit. As the name says, it's ready to fit, it's glazed, it's sealed in factory, and this is a very nice option for the homeowner to basically get around a few of the issues that you generally have with a sort of a raw product, a raw timber product, when you buy it and you want to install it. So that's something which we've got. It is pre-sealed and glazed, as I said, so yeah, that's an option for the homeowner.
Something about wooden windows, it's probably taken a little bit of heat, is, sorry, excuse the pun, is it didn't seal properly. Historically, a wooden window did. Now, obviously, you've overcome that problem with this product.
Yeah, look, we had to obviously comply with the regulations when they came in. 10400XA was a sort of a big sort of game changer for Swartland. We had to sort of get all of our tooling and everything correct and change everything to be more energy efficient. Obviously, to have windows sealed correctly, you've got to have a proper composite gasket and a seal. To make the window close, make sure you haven't got any air leakage or anything like that happening on the window. That's what we do. We've got a very, very energy efficient product, and it complies with all the regulations.
Samantha, thanks for coming to chat to us.
Thank you, Graham.
And your speciality, or you're a specialist at, is aluminium. Now, aluminium traditionally has always sealed quite well. You've always had seals on and so on. So it's good to hear that you can now buy timber window frames that have those same qualities. When it comes to standard windows, Samantha, do you guys make standard windows that I could look at in a catalogue?
Yes, we here at our range of aluminium windows at Swartland is called Kenzo, and you'll find them in most of our merchants in South Africa, across South Africa, and you can buy them off the shelf. And we have Mark, who is our actual in-house architect, that can help the homeowner design his own house using standard windows, which inevitably ends up being cheaper due to the manufacturing processes and so forth.
Contemporary architecture has a lot of glass in it, and I sometimes refer to them as fish tanks, which I shouldn't do, particularly when Kevin from PG is here, because these guys sell glass, okay? But using that much glass generally means that they are specialized or custom-made window frames. So, Mark, back to wood, we know that your timber windows, wooden windows, you guys do make standard windows. Can you handle custom design as well?
Graham, yes, we can. When it comes to our timber range, specifically our Cape Culture range, we do most certainly allow for custom made product. Generally, when you're talking sort of contemporary architecture, that sort of entails a lot of curtain walls and that type of thing. We can do, to a certain extent, we can do use to utilize timber, but timber, obviously being the material that it is, we are sort of restricted to the sizes that we can go. But from a custom point of view, there is definitely some scope for that.
When it comes to style, I think of game lodges. Some years ago, we were involved in a lot of game lodges. And if you didn't put a timber window in, you would be fired. Game lodges aren't as popular as they used to be, and they've moved away from those traditions. But do you find that people come to you with a certain style, maybe a Cape Dutch or something, that they go, timber has to be the right way to go?
Look, you do definitely have your sort of more classical sort of architecture, your kind of Victorian, Georgian styles. Those are obviously very, very suited towards timber. We also got a lot of people doing sort of these more sort of contemporary sort of farmhouse styles too, that are also going for your timber style window. So your timber type window, so your sliding sash and your more sort of classical style windows, they are very suited for that kind of architecture as well.
When we come back, Mark and Samantha, I want to chat to you about quality and how one understands the difference between a good window and a bad window. Build Aid on Mix, brought to you by AfriSam. My name is Graham Alexander. We're chatting about windows. Mark Cross and Samantha Cross from Swartland, and we're chatting about wooden windows and aluminium windows. As Peter explained earlier, conductance through a window frame, how the heat transfers through a window frame. Wood and aluminium probably have very different properties in that regard. And my guess is wood would probably be better, Mark, than aluminium.
Well, better in conductance.
Yeah, or a better insulator.
I don't think so. generally, timber probably would be one of the better ones. Aluminium being sort of metal, aluminium. Like you guys discussed a little bit earlier, when you've sort of put a rod of aluminium or a rod of steel in the fire, if you grab that and you put a piece of wood in the fire, which one is going to be the hotter one? It's obviously going to be the metal one. So aluminium is obviously not as good a conductor. It is a much better conductor than wood. So wood would obviously be your first choice from an insulation point of view.
Samantha, you guys have a solution, the aluminium window business, in putting what's called a thermal break into a frame so that it doesn't conduct like a piece of metal over a fire.
Yes. What happens is, with the aluminium, obviously the aluminium section on the window itself conducts quite seriously. So a lot of manufacturers have now come up with what you call a thermal break, and it's basically a little piece of plastic that breaks the conduction through the aluminium profile itself.
So in simple terms, it's like two frames.
Yes.
Joined with a piece of rubber.
But that, I must admit, is in conjunction with the right glass. We talking about the outer frame, but in conjunction with the right glass, you can gain a very low energy efficiency ratio with using those products.
Yeah, one has to look at it as a system, and Kevin's going to join us in a while to chat more about the glazing part of it, particularly with conductance and double glazing. When it comes to, we talked about wooden windows and your newer range now that seals, part of the energy talk and saving energy is also about not allowing air to flow through gaps and so on. I think aluminium, it goes without saying, is always sealed quite well. And now with a timber product, you're doing exactly the same.
I just want to mention that even the gasket themselves, over the last number of years, have just improved and improved and improved. Before, you had a gasket that you would pull and it would stay there and stretch, or in weather reduce and not go back to where it was, so you'd have gaps in those windows and they wouldn't last as long. The gaskets now have what they call a memory in them, and those gaskets stay. So even in a cold or heated environment, they stay in the same form as when you put them in the window.
When it comes to quality, I mean, I think it goes without saying that your company produces quality products. But as a consumer, I get a price on a window. I have a picture of a window. It may come off of my plans, or the architect produces it. And someone says that window is 900 Rand. And then someone pops up and says, no, I've got one for 400 Rand. There's probably a good reason for that. When it comes to wooden windows, Mark, how would a consumer check quality? What do you look for?
Graham, I think what you've got to take into consideration is look at the name of the company, the brand. Obviously, the price like you were saying, is important. If you're looking at a 900 rand window versus a 600 rand window, you obviously the 600 rand window generally the quality perhaps is not the same. The timber section size that you've got to look at. If you're looking at a nice thick timber section, that's possibly going to be a little bit more expensive than a slightly thinner timber section. But I think when you're looking at a thicker section, quality wise, you know, you're definitely going to have more longevity on the product.
Price is always a good guide. Now, you don't want to pay too much for something, but shop around, particularly when you're talking about windows in your new home. It's a big part of the budget. Talk to guys like Swartlon, to guys like Tiva. Check it out. And be careful of that low price, because there's a reason there's a low price. We chat about this often on this radio show and at the workshops that we do, that the price wasn't worked out correctly in the beginning, generally on most projects. And as it goes on and progresses, you find out that that budget was the wrong one and the builder underquoted. And then homeowners and contractors or consumers start making wrong decisions and knowingly buy bad quality, because there's no option. They've run out of money. So planning, what we're talking about, and the homeowner workshops that Kay was talking about, that is promoted by Mix FM, we go through this, that homeowners and architects spend some time, get the budget right, use the right stuff. We're talking about Bosch power tools this evening. That's a brand that everybody knows. I've got a Bosch drill in my cupboard, and Simon has some tips on using these things, or using a drill, I think.
So the Bosch DIY Minute is brought to you by Bosch, obviously, invented for life. So in line with the gift we're giving away, which is the 91-piece X-Line titanium set, which will get you drilling and screwing non-stop, so don't start giggling on that one. Yeah, here's a tip for all of you DIYs out there. When you're drilling a hole in the wall, you take a piece of paper or a post-it note and you fold it in half and you stick that piece of paper on the wall, just under the hole where you're going to drill. And as you drill, all that brick dust, all that concrete rubble, everything will get caught into that piece of paper, and you don't have to actually vacuum up or have that horrible brown streak running down your wall when you've got to wipe it off with a wet cloth. So, yeah.
It sounds like a brilliant concept, but then back to quality, Simon. Yeah. You need a quality post-it thing to stick to the wall.
You need a quality post-it, or you need a quality bit of Prestick, I think it is, that case here, that we stick on an A4 piece of paper on the wall. So yeah. So the Bosch DIY Minute is brought to you by Bosch, invented for life.
We're chatting about windows. And at the moment, we're talking about wooden windows and aluminium windows. And I'm talking to Mark and Samantha from Swartland. Talking quality, we understand with wood, you can look at the section, you can check it by price. I'm sure you can check the density of the wood, if it's a bit soft and so on. With aluminium, it may be a little bit more difficult, or do the same rules apply?
It is a little bit more difficult, I must admit, because from the first look at the aluminium, they look the same. What the homeowner must keep in mind is the thickness of the actual product. A lot of them go very paper thin, and they become actually useless as a feature in the house. So you must look and try and stay with a 3 to 4 mil thick product. And then there's another thing that you've got to think about is the actual aluminium itself, how much tin's involved and how it's tempered and a whole lot of things. So a product that's SABS approved and it's got all the SANS 613 that we spoke about earlier and it complies, I think that's what the owner needs to look at.
Sam, I think branding and guarantee is also something to look at as well. You know, every consumer wants to know that they've got some kind of a backup.
Yeah. Okay. Like Swartland, you know, you go to the website, Swartland's been around for years. It's a household name, certainly a construction industry. That must be a guide.
Absolutely. You know, Swartland's not going anywhere. So, you know, that's something to look for.
Yeah. Mark, thanks for chatting to us. Samantha, stay with us. Kevin's going to join us. And we're going to talk about glass in relationship to windows and just about glass. There must be so much love in my heart that it would tear me apart. And I know, although you couldn't see,